a doggy. The first time. Okay. Like, I was a nervous kid.
Of course, so was I.
But did you ever have a nervous stomach?
Yes, all the time.
Did you ever attend a choir class?
No, well, maybe I had to at one point in my life.
Were you ever standing on the bleachers? And did you ever just, you couldn't hold it in?
No, I was a good holder in
there. And it just did what it had to do?
Took its course.
And you fart, but it's not any old fart.
It's the lethal kind.
It's like, woo! And then everybody parts like the Red Sea. Okay? People to my left, they way on the left. People on my right, way on the right. I'm just standing there going, I gotta pick a side because they're gonna know it's me.
Was it when people were singing? It was in the middle of the song.
I'm like, you know, trying to like squeeze my butt cheeks. I'm crossing my legs. Like, I'm doing all the moves. I'm like waiting till we're allowed to sit down so I could like sit on my foot. I'm like trying to like shove back up.
Anything you can.
And I'm like trying all my tricks. They usually get me through the day until I can get home and like feel comfy in my house. So, the class, they all part like the Red Sea. And then I got inside. They all stop. So now I have to decide, where do I go? So then the choir teacher, Mrs. Vinegar, right?
Mrs. Vinegar.
Vinegar. Oh. It sounds like vinegar. It's vinegar, right?
Enough smells in the room right now.
Okay, she was like my teacher for most of like middle school, minus I think she had a baby and a man came in and took over.
I remember Mrs. Vinegar.
Yeah, Miss Winnegar, the choir teacher. So she's at the piano and we're doing our la-di-da songs. And all of a sudden, we part like the Red Sea. And I gotta decide where to go.
So
right?
Go left or right?
So she stops and goes, what? Like, what's wrong with everybody? Well, I need to know what's the matter with everybody. It's 8th grade choir class. Why did we all just stop singing? She might have called class early and like went home on a sick leave or something.
Killing me.
So she's just like, everyone not like get over it, knock out of it, like grow up, like right, get on with your life.
So, what were you singing, do you remember?
Oh, I don't know.
Wind Beneath.
I know
wings.
For the longest time we were practicing that song, Proud to Be an American, but she didn't like how we were doing it. And then she went on leave and the man came in and she's like, maybe he'll do it. I remember the one year we were doing Cabernet.
Maybe they should have been singing No Air, No Air.
So I'm like, okay, like, yeah, we go back, class resumes. Okay, I don't know if windows are open or not, but I just know, like, it's back now, we're done. We, like, kind of got dismissed quasi a little early. And I don't know why. Like you can. The rules are you can't leave until the bell dings, right? But yet, for whatever reason, no. People like to huddle by the door. So as soon as that bell rings, they can just go. But where are you going? Unless you have lunch next, like what's the hurry? So
to get some air.
Now everyone, they're all huddled up. They're just chit chatting. They're doing their thing, and I'm like, uh-oh, right?
Fire number two.
Fire no. So I let it out again. But this time, we're all like a before you let the stampede out or something, right? Like we all like in a huddle.
Yes. As if they weren't hurrying enough.
And these are bad, okay? So I let it out. And the poor color blanket.
Wish she was nose blind.
Starts choking and coughing and gagging. And then the next thing I know, I hear it smells like rotten eggs. And then later that day, I was sitting next to someone who I didn't realize until you told me, and even then to convincing that I had a crush on, I farted a little bit and study skills, and he gave me a dirty look and like kind of moved away. But we were on the airplane to come here, and someone's letting it rip, and I got a whiff of it, and I said to her, it's like 8th grade chorus class all over again.
And you're in a freaking airplane. There's nowhere to run, no doors.
But now when you hear that story, you have like a nasal visual, you know? Yeah, you can now really appreciate what that poor kid and everyone that class went through.
Especially the colorblind kid.
He was like right next to me.
Oh, man.
But again, I tried everything I could to hold it in.
I'm sure you did.
And out it went.
Oh, man. All right, we're going to just dump the packages right here for a hot second. And then I will move the car. Final word is that was hilarious.
Trista.